While the heroine keeps waiting for her sakhi and her hero to show up, let us now pause and take this opportunity to felicitate and honor our chief guest and fellow artists. I now invite our chief guest, Srimati Jayanti Ramachandra, director, Sri Charan Academy of Fine Arts, to kindly join us on the stage. I also invite our guru, Vidushi Srimati Mridula Rai, and Sahitya's parents to the stage. I'm glad to share a few words about Srimati Jayanti. Kalai Mamani Srimati Jayanti Ramachandra has been trained and groomed to be an excellent exponent of the Varuvur Bani of Bharatanatyam by Guru Samar Raj, son of the dance maestro Varuvur Sri Ramaya Pillai. For over 3 decades, she has had the unique privilege and opportunity of performing solely under the Natuvangam of her guru. Her presentations are a judicious combination of graceful movements and crisp footwork, passionately blending with the rhythm of the Varuvur Jatis. As a leading dancer of the Bani, she has performed in the prime slots of most of the leading sabhas in Chennai during Madras Music Festival at Music Academy, Indian Fine Arts Society, Muttamil Peravai, Tamilisai Sangam, to name a few. Over the years, she has performed in many prestigious events all across the US, UK, Europe, Asia, and India. She has also invited to perform along with her guru at the Carnegie Hall, New York. She has been bestowed with various titles such as Kalai Mamani, Nritya Jyoti, Natya Tendral, Abhinaya Devi, and Kalai Sudarmani, and doctorate from the University of Peace, Tonga. Her performance over the past years have won her acclaim from various art connoisseurs like Srimati Kamala Lakshmanan, Srimati Bala Saraswati, Srimati Vaijayanti Mala, Srimati M.S. Subhalakshmi, Srimati M.L. Vasanta Kumari, Srimati D.K. Pattammal, Sri Madurai Somasundaram Pillai, and Sri Kunnakudi Vaidyanathan. Apart from being a soloist, Srimati Jayanti has played key roles in many dance ballets composed by her guru. As a true mark of respect for the Guru Sishya Parampara, Sri Charan Academy of Fine Arts commits itself to sponsor the annual Varuvur Festival at Chennai. Every year, the students of Sri Charan participate at the Natya Arpana event at Varuvur Temple during the Arudra Utsavam. Srimati Jayanti has also choreographed thematic compositions like Agamum Puramum, Pasumai, and Prabandhasaram. A multifaceted personality, Srimati Jayanti is the managing director of VTX Industries Limited, a vertically integrated textile company in Coimbatore. We are very glad to have you here, ma'am. Now, I request Mridula ma'am to present a token of love to our chief guest, Srimati Jayanti Ramachandra. Now, I request Srimati Jayanti ma'am to share a few words with us, please.
Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. At the outset, I would like to thank everybody present here, Guru Srimati Mridula Rai, and the parents of Sahitya, to have thought and come to the stage of Arangetram. It's a huge, huge, huge task, and all of us know what it is, to bring every kid to that stage. So I thank, because every kid, one more step towards Bharatanatyam, to the universe of God, is really what we all intend to do. And I'm sure Mridula is also joining me to say this. Today has been a great day, a great outcoming after all the corona and the silence. We pray, and this, as dancers and teachers and artists, we all, this is our way of requesting nature. Who else other than the cosmic God can help us move on with life. So first of all, I thank the opportunity given to me to come here today. A few words about where I come from or where is Natya, and then about what's happening today. Natya, Bharatanatyam, has come a long way. It is a huge circle. It comes from the basic movements of everything in the universe, formalized into some kind of a folk, some kind of entertainment, and then went into more formalization, into Shastra, into Natya, and then has come into the world. It became at one point an entertainment at the temple, an entertainment in devotion, and a committee of entertainers. And then it came on towards society and a communication system, and we still maintain a little bit of entertainment, a lot of diversion. And today it's, I think art is moving towards preserving culture, preserving where we come from, reaching back to our roots. So important in this world of fast pace, world of technology. Now it's become world of the computer screen. It is so important to connect oneself with everything around, with the great Shastras. So I think Bharatanatyam is one of the most unique forms that has the capability and the bandwidth to really connect. Because the teacher, the student, and every one of the artists today, they have to be in unison. It's just not your thought, it's just not your body, it's just not your action. It's all about what the teacher got into her, what she wanted her student to do. And it's all about the student receiving everything that the teacher said. And then it's all about giving it out to all of us who are watching. And the biggest system that can help us, the beautiful media, the great artists who help us do it. There's nothing, there's just not one thing that is different. So all of it brings us to what we are and where we are. So can you imagine the training? Can you imagine what the connection is? And can you imagine how far it can spread? And that is Bharatanatyam to me, and to, I'm sure, all of us. Today was a beautiful day. I should first talk about the Guru's teaching, the training, and then, yes, I think she needs a real big hand for everything she's been doing. You know, it's like, it's one thing to dance. It's very easy to decide, and there's so much media, so much information from nowadays to pick up beautiful items. But to digest it and actually bring it to the level of your student and make the level the superb is really a teacher's job. And I'm sure you'll all agree that's been done in a beautiful way. And all the coming in front of a stage, standing to dance in front of people, it needs a lot more emotion than just not dancing. And that surely comes from the training of the teacher, and then it develops from the student. So congratulations, ma'am. You've done a great job. Recollecting myself, my arangetram was here in this stage. I just realized it when I was walking in. Just a few words of how Bharatanatyam was at that point of time, I think 5 decades back. Bharatanatyam is literally not for people of society then. If when I danced, my family members, my father is a great, he had a great interest in music, and they had some associations with the studios around Coimbatore, basically they're business people. But they took the first step to allow me to dance. But at that point, it was never to be done. After that first step, Samarangetum, little girl, nice dressed well, nice occasion for the families to get together. But what is the step after that was a very big no-no. There was a lot to do, you know, culture, art. Maybe music was a great thing, but not dance. Dance was not for society. From there, and hardly teachers were available because there was not many aversions, not many way to grow for artists at that point of time. Everything, we went to Chennai. From there, I think today we can stand up, right? Stand up strong. Coimbatore can give all that art can. We have all the traditions, we have all the commitments. And also I think since we come from a background of calmness, we are more secure about what we do. And so it's a great thought process for me. The little dance, what you do and the stage, I don't think at that age, I think I was 11, I thought I'll come back to be a chief guest. That's where art takes you, really takes you above. A small word, I mean, I want to talk about the artist today, the hero of the day. You all will agree with me. I don't think this looks like the first step of her career. She looks like she's been a professional born dancing, right? She's been so confident, so perfect with everything that she did. I don't think she had a fear. She wasn't looking at her teacher. She was doing it on her own. And that is what it is. All of that, I know I have to respect the innate talent that little girl had, Savithya had. But it is the teacher who has given all that confidence to come up with it. She had a beautiful stance. As a dancer, the first stance, they come to the stage, and when they stand, the way they carry, dancers, we know it's done or it's not done. Savithya had it all. She has the structure, she had the stance, the way to carry her mudras, every mudra was perfect, her radhavus, everything was done well, too well coordinated with the rhythm of the music. And there was this abhinaya that was layered in so many forms. They were explaining it very well, beautifully collected songs, well done, and beautifully delineated. That is what it is, to start with a step. And then, nowadays, with all the challenges, and I'm sure she also had a break with the corona, right? There must have been so much of a break, such a challenge to sit in front of a screen and try to teach an art that is blood and soul. And so with that break, they have achieved a great step. So to Savithya, and a word of praise to the parents. In these days, surely they need it. So today the world goes by marks, plus two, then college, and where, what college? Now it's not India, it's not even inside India, it's about which country. I think there was choices between US and UK, but now it's like I am too old to understand the different subjects and the different things that go on. Among all these choices and all the promises these choices give the child, the parents have chosen to stick to something that is grassroots. Base, what is needed to be a good human and what is needed to face the challenge of the world? Art. And above art, it is Bharatanatyam. Because Bharatanatyam has to digest everything inside. So I really commend the parents to have taken this broad, very strong step. Mind you, this art is very challenging, financially and time consuming. All of it, they have braved it, and together, teacher, the student and the parents have done a great job. And this is one to all of us who are committed to this art. Today, I will fail in my responsibilities if I do not appreciate the team around here. First, she did a beautiful natuvangam, dancing, doing the steps with our feet. You know, dancers, the feet can do anything we want. The arms can do anything we don't. But we have not been natuvanas. I hope you agree. Because I come learning from a natuvanar. Natuvanars do not dance after a point those days. They stopped after their basics. They never danced. They focused only on their natuvangam. Because the syllables that we recite are very powerful. Very powerful. And so they focus on their natuvangam. Today, the challenge for all of us is to dance, then teach, and also do the natuvangam. She did a real great job. A lot of complicated rhythms, patterns, and it was really good. Congratulations. Today, her success would never be what we see today, but for the great family of musicians that helped her and Sahitya to do this job. All of them, I think in Coimbatore we've become one big music family. They all seem so much of us, part of us, that Mr. Praveen on the music, I've seen him singing, and that music, I'm sure, pushes Sahitya to do the Abhinayam out and helps Mrudula to sit in confidence. I know what it is. It really needs that support. And then Mr. Vishwanathan, I mean, everybody knows the big responsibility that he's taken, the huge efforts he's doing to promote art, and what a great job. We don't know to tell whether the foot or the words or the mridangam worked. All of them together, it was a beautiful show. And of course, Mr. Sivaramakrishnan, for me, he's been there from the day I started becoming a teacher, when I performed and teacher. Beautiful artist. It's not just about how complicated you could do that music, but how sweet and the manasukku idama, and along with what they do. So you all know it, I just want to say it. Beautiful way he joined into the team and enhanced it. And Mr. Vasant on the flute. A flute that can get drowned or can just push up. Everything in its place in the right side. It was a great job, and I think I'll fail if I do not praise all the other colleagues of Sahitya. Maybe they're the students of Mrudula who are so enthusiastic. So it's like a family function. And that is what Bharatanatyam does to us today. To become a family, to be united, and to achieve. And that is what we need in the world today. To be honest, Corona was really bad to all of us. It hit us economy so much. But if our heart survived it, it's because we had the art inside. And we could keep beating it. So we need it. We don't know how many more waves and what different more things come. As long as art lives, we will live. So, and last but not the least, Mr. Mahesh. Mahesh and his wife. Everybody knows he's all around getting everything perfect, making her look so beautiful and get everything done. Takes so much of the burden out of the parents and the teacher. So Mahesh and both of you, I really appreciate the sound, the music, everything together gives this great day. I pray to my Guru, to the Almighty, and to Lord Nataraja to give Sahitya and her teacher lot more miles to grow and bring fame to Coimbatore and this great art. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your sweet words. I take this opportunity to share a few words about our guru, Srimati Mrudula Rai. Mrudula ma'am, founder of Sri Natiniketan, is a dancer and teacher with over 25 years of experience. She began learning Bharatanatyam from Guru Shri Ullal Mohan Kumar from the age of 8 and furthered her training under Srimati Shobana Balachandra, the youngest of the trio sisters. A well-trained yoga and kalaripayattu artist, she started SNN from humble beginnings and now it has created an undeniable legacy. Be it curating Drityarpana, a dance festival intended to bring in budding new talents together from across the country, or creating a perfect amalgamation between modern and traditional ideas to birth new abstract concepts like Tsunami, Its Fury, Veerabhadra, Panchabhuta, Celluloid, just to name a few, she has been a living testament to the impact of Bharatanatyam in South India. She has performed at prestigious stages in India, UK, Germany, Dubai, Sri Lanka, etc. She has been the recipient of various awards like Vasant Shresht, Vocational Service Awards, Nritya Vasant Award, Mayura Natvanga Nanmani, Natya Visharadha by Udupi Krishnamat, Kovai's Champion, the Unsung Heroine, to name a few. Now I call upon Sahitya's parents, Srimati Pungurali and Sri Chandramavali, to present a small token of love to our Guru. It goes without saying that the soul of today's performance was truly enhanced and nourished by the beautiful rendition of our wonderful musicians who never failed to create magic in every concert. We take this opportunity to honor them. I request our chief guest, Srimati Jayanti Ma'am, to present mementos to our musicians. I now call upon Sri Porukudi G.R. Praveen Sir for the soul-soothing vocal rendition. I invite Sri Mayavaram T. Vishwanathan Sir for his everlasting support for SNN and an exemplary Mridangam Vidwan. I next call upon Sri Palakkad Sivaramakrishnan Sir for the melodious violin rendition. I invite Sri Tanjay Vasant Kumar Sir for his soul-soothing flute. A dance recital or event of this kind is not possible without the support of our backstage artists. We would like to present them with mementos in appreciation of their support, love and artistry. I now call upon our dear Maheshanna and Deepaka, our makeup artists and stage record designer. I request our chief guest to present them with the mementos. I next invite Ayyappananna on behalf of his team for the videography and photography support. I call upon RSS and team for the incredible sound and lighting support. Today's delicious dinner is arranged by Vinayaga Catering. I would like to call them upon stage to receive the memento. I like to extend my credits to this auditorium, Citra Hall, and costumes, Sunil, Mangalore. Now, Mridula Ma'am would like to present a small token of love to Sahitya. We would like to thank Meeraka for her beautiful MC. I now hand over the mic to Varsha and Sahitya, who would like to share a few words about the heroine of today, Sahitya. Sorry, Varsha and Smriti. Good evening to everyone present here. We have known Sahitya since second grade. I've always seen her and wondered, where does she get so much energy from? She's been an active and an enthusiastic person since then. Sahitya is an incredible artist and is very passionate about everything she does. No matter how much work, she will definitely find time to dance and maintain her fitness every day. She has a very creative mind, and that's why she never settles for old traditional ideas. It's always her motto to try something new. She's ready to take up challenges and gives her best to accomplish that. She always competes with herself to become better each and every time. Whenever we choreograph a dance, she'll be the one giving a lot of creative ideas and always persuades us to do challenging steps. She's a very clear-headed person and takes one step at a time. Being a science student, it is very difficult to balance studies and extracurricular activities, but Sahitya manages both really well. She is a bundle of talent. When we have annual day or any cultural fest in our school, her name will be on every list. We would usually be tired after practicing dance, but she'll finish dance and go for singing practice and to the next one. She's a very talented and a humble person. We are immensely happy and proud to watch her dance, which is a treat to our eyes. We wish her all the very best for her upcoming dance journey. Thank you.
Thank you so much, girls. Sahitya's parents have a special token of love to Adyar Kalayanti for her everlasting moral support. Coordinating everything. Thank you so much, Kalayanti. Thank you so much for your patience. We can now continue with the rest half of the Arangetram.